somebody who's having chest pain should call 911. I often tell my patients that I would rather you would come to the emergency room, be evaluated for what isn't a heart attack, than to stay home, have a heart attack, and then end up in severe problems. So I think if you're of any concern that this is a heart attack or a heart attack developing, call 911. Make sure you take care of yourself, and then we all learn from that. Not always. Many patients don't understand that, in fact, a third of people don't have any symptoms of the heart attack itself. They sometimes just have symptoms of what we think about as the heart not functioning normally. So at a time where you have an artery occlusion, many people may not feel the chest pain or the shoulder pain or the jaw pain, which is classic we think about, but might feel short of breath. They might be short of breath with activity. They may actually even have some stomach indigestion type symptoms. Not always. Women often don't have the severity of the symptoms. They don't have the classic warnings that we think about, the chest pain, the elephant sitting on my chest, the arm pain. They're more likely to have atypical symptoms, such as short of breath, dyspnea. And again, some people don't have any symptoms at all. As you get older, there's a heart attack risk. One of the number one predictors for developing heart disease and a stroke is being old enough. We know that people in their 20s and 30s have narrowing of their arteries that gradually develops and progresses to the point where they have their heart attack at the age of 55 or 60. So even though you might be healthy and thin, you still might have the genetic predisposition or the risk for developing coronary disease and heart attack or stroke. So making sure you think about those things when you're 20, when you're 30, or when you're 40 can often prevent disease progression to the point where you would prevent having a heart attack when you're 55 or 65. I always think of the patient I took care of who was 35 years old and had a heart attack. Very athletic, vegetarian, but he still was having a heart attack. And as I told him, if he hadn't done those things, he maybe have had that heart attack earlier. There's an increased risk for him and his family for having early heart disease. So taking care of yourself and doing the right things is clearly an important step, but also knowing what your individual risk is the right thing. Generally true, but what we really need to understand is that a total cholesterol can be elevated for a couple different reasons. It can be elevated with disproportionately high bad cholesterol. It can also be elevated with good cholesterol. So what we really need to do is look at the different components of the total cholesterol and say, is that an adverse risk? Is this a profile that's going to lend me towards a heart attack? So I think yes, but we still need to be smarter about it and know more information. That's a common misperception. To develop a heart attack is years and years of accumulation of lipids in the artery, developing that plaque. So the issue of having your heart attack today only reflects those years of accumulation. And I think you were healthy yesterday and that you weren't bothered, but you truly had the disease that was progressing. It was what we'd call subclinical. It was present, but you weren't bothered by it. Today you're bothered when your heart attack. So I think it's again a reflection of long time accumulation.